If we just have loadout and we don't have anything else on the loadout, just meats and hardpoint items, lifeboat class, nothing much on it. Okay, so find match solo. Let's see. If we are a rookie, create ping results if we're a rookie. Construct matchmaking. Guess I could add a few more events in here. So it looks like it's the where would we put something like this? I mean, basically it would be the player controller would need to call the server and say, hey, this is what I am. Begin shame hack fixed. Alt tab and Windows just roll with it. Yeah, I see how it is. Okay, if not server, if is dedicated server, return, otherwise begin play. What we could do here is set our, could call our server and tell it that. We want something done, right? All right. So what we're going to do is we are going to have the player controller go ahead and send some information to the should probably put a structure in here. Okay, so it's basically we're going to want the player state. Yeah, so maelstrom player state. Which is going to have stuff on it. So let's add another ustruct here, which we are going to call fmaelstrom player telemetry. And we'll have our basic stuff. So, bool. He is rookie is going to be the first one. We can also report a few other things, right? So we could have an F string for the client session ID. And let's add the maelstrom telemetry in here. So let's go to the player state. So do rep lifetime telemetry data. Only the player himself may know how much gold he earned. Condition owner only? So, we need to send this player state. So, player controller, we need our struct. All right, so so if we got the telemetry info, we're gonna want the player state, which is gonna have the his rookie needs to be set, and we need the client session ID. So let's see if we can get the telemetry utils. So if we can grab the session ID, basically in the player controller here. All right, let's see. Where is this all called? So I'll get the session ID, send that to the server. And we're going to need the isRookie. Alright, so we'll call the setTelemetryInfo, which will have that information on it, and then inside of our telemetryutils, So we've got our player state, which has our telemetry data on it. And we've got our his rookie. So we need to add these guys. This is going to be veteran, which is an int, and then we have client session ID, which is a string 36. All right. Let's see if that builds for us. So that's going to add our client session ID and our veteran seed to our server tag. Let's play the header dance. All right. Well, we'll just keep looking at this. Well, let's make sure that our client is actually sending its information to the server. Well, let's see how it goes. So we did get our information. And our telemetry is rookie is false, client session ID, and server session ID. All right. Alright, so let's look at our integer properties. Veteran is 1, and our client session ID is right there. And game ID is right there. Net mode, everything's looking good. Alright, so that's our matchmaking tier stuff. I hate Skype. It's such a pile of garbage. Like, it lags. I don't understand why it lags. Like, So yeah, right now the next thing would be adding in some damage stuff. Basically, so we could have damage sources. So let me see. There is this inside of Maelstrom Ship. There is take damage implementation, which has all this stuff. But the problem is, we're firing like, 30 cannonballs at somebody. So we don't want to send 30 take damage events or some bullshit, right? Like, that's not gonna work. I mean, like, good job. We dealt damage. We're gonna send 30 events? That's a lot of damage events. That's too much data. We do not want to send that. Every player death, that's fine. Every, like, big thing, like, hey, I rammed you for a certain amount of damage, like maybe. Okay, so we have our incoming damage structures, hull damage, projectile, all this sort of stuff. What's our call stack look like? Looks like this is all begin overlaps inside of cannonballs. So it looks like we have buffered damage events. Let me see. Projectile damage. Let's see what happens when I ram this guy. So, outcome type repair? What? Starboard armor. Oh, that's just a repair thing. Okay, this one is, though. Incoming damage sources ramming. And this one. We've got ramming damage. All right, so what are these outcome types? I'm trying to think. Basically, what they're saying is that we have these events that get buffered up and then flushed, and there's just tons of damage events that are happening. So let's see, where is this? Yeah, I'm trying to think of a good way to do this because basically what we'd want is ships to have some sort of damage. Like I want to know what damage is being caused from which sources, such as ramming damage is accounting for many, 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 lots of the, it's ramming damage accounts for one third of all damage that contributed to the ship dying. Okay, that makes sense. So I think we want some sort of damage event where we count up the amount of data that has. The amount of damage that has been taken. So I think, yeah, trying to think here about what we actually want. Basically, what we'd want is an attack type, which would have the information on it. Well, I think I'll just kind of leave this alone then for now. Unless there's something else. All right, so if we're gonna make a kind of a ship average damage, basically, I think it's that we need to add to the player state, kind of like how we have this player score structure. We need another player state thing with damage sources by type. So so what would this look like? Basically, we'd have so what kind of types do we have anyway? Damage type. Damage source type. Okay, so basically we would have projectile damage, ramming damage. Swallowing damage. And we'd have totals and projectile damages. I guess we can do projectile hits, boarding hits, and swallowing hits. So the big concern that they've got is so the big concern is this function's already getting out of hand. So they're like, you know, if you add a whole bunch of stuff here, sure, but, you know, it's kind of a It's kind of a big ass problem here. Process sail damage. Alright, so I think I'll just do a pretty simple sort of thing here for just ramming hits and the rest. And I think it's just the player state needs a function on it, which takes on like RAM and the rest. Alright, so we need the damage source types, and I should just get back into focus. Kind of a quiet stream because I'm just doing stuff. So hit equals the address of damage dot projectile hits. Total address. Damage dot projectile damage total. Ramming hits, boarding hits, swallowing hits, it's spelled boarding properly.